Yo, what's up everybody? It's me, Robert Moraine, and today I'm going to be reacting and critiquing your dance videos. Let's do this. So a few weeks ago, I reached out to all of you on all of my social media platforms and asked you guys to submit your dance videos, your links to your dance videos, your YouTube videos, your Musical.ly videos, so that way I could critique and react to them. So today I'm going to do just that. It's been a few weeks, but I'm finally getting around to doing it. I have a setup to where I could do this and make it look as professional as I can. So let's get right into this. And a little disclaimer before I start. I'm not the all-knowing master popper of the universe. Everything I say, you should take with a grain of salt. This is going to be a really subjective critique, and it's just my opinion, so please do not be offended. I'm just going to point out little details that I think you could probably work on, and that I think people might benefit from me pointing out. So that being said, let's get into the first video. The first video is submitted by Tony Pham. Tony, here we go. Critique, react to your video. All right. Feeling it. Grooving. Nice. Nice. Tut from behind the head to wave around the body. Continuing the weird tuts, I like that. Not losing the groove. Yo. First thing, really, really dig the tut move from behind the head to getting awkward and weird and fake and then going down and then waving out of that and then continuing into your combo. That was really cool. I liked how you stayed musical. You kept the same groove throughout the track, which was cool because you were doing some pretty awkward, unique tutting movements. And to keep your groove with that kind of motion, I think is a good call. Something I would work on is giving your head a focus. You could give intention to your dance by playing with your eyes and telling a story with your eyes and with your head. So right here, you're a little bit lost in your dance, which is really cool. And it gives this kind of a poetic feeling to dance. But you could really take charge, like a lot of the pros do, and use your regard and your focus to tell the audience where to look while you're dancing, or tell the audience how to feel when you're dancing. For example, if you were to wave, and you were just looking straight at somebody while you wave. That's cool, but you could also look at your wave, look at the person, give a little pause, and then return to your wave and tell like a little bit of a story and give a little bit more detail to the wave and make the wave not just a wave, but a part of your overall story or whatever you're trying to express. So it's just something to think about. And I think it's something that a lot of dancers could improve upon, just giving your head a focus. Remember that it's there. It's all good if you don't really agree with me, but it's just something that you might be able to work on next time, maybe, if you feel like it. So thank you for submitting, Tony. Hope it helps someone out there. That being said, let's get into the next video, who was submitted by Antoine Moogs Weber on Instagram. Let's check it out. Nice. Nice speed changes in there. Zooms. Glitches. Nice color. Really good effects. Even animation in there. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna stop it right here. Antoine, really cool video. I love all of the effects and the glitching. It's really like robot-y, futuristic, future dub looking. Really cool effects, really cool video editing. I like it. The only problem I have with this video personally, and this is my opinion, of course, is that there's not enough time to just watch and focus on your dancing. So there wasn't even a moment in there where I could see you dance for over 4 or 5 seconds, which is a problem for this video because I can't really give you an honest critique on your dancing if I can't really watch you dance. Maybe you can use the editing effect, like swooshing in and out of different locations as an intro. And then when the song drops, you could like do the dance bit. But the editing was really cool. I liked how there was a bunch of locations. I liked the color. I liked the vibe. I liked the music. So next time I would just do a little bit more dancing. Thanks for submitting, Antoine. I'm sorry that my critique was a little bit incomplete. So the next video is by Antrik Sharma. And let's get into this. Intrix. Nice, I like the background and the music. And that you're on a boat with the moving water. Really cool. What city is that? I don't know what city that is. Nice. Nice, you did like the same move but the other direction. Clean, isolated movement. I like it. Nice. Shot and caught the arrow, telling stories, broke the arrow. Cool. Ah, wish you continued that combo. Clean waves. Neck isolation. Little glide. Animating. Very cool. That's enough of that. Intrix, really cool video. I like the backdrop. I like the vibe of it. It's cool. You're like on vacation somewhere nice on the river. Really cool video. Really nice vibe. I like it. A couple of things that I like about your dancing would be you're really isolated. You take your time. You look comfortable. You don't look rushed or like you're trying to do too much at once. I liked a few of your little moves that you made up that are really cool, especially that one where you kind of lean and then wave back out of it. That's a nice little effect you got going there. A couple of things that I would point out that I noticed is that the head isolation move you did a couple of times. You did about 3 or 4 times. Maybe you can cut back on that a little bit. I know it's a cool move and it has a great effect and it's an easy go-to. It's a pretty simple move to get a great effect out of, and that's why I do it as well. But I would only do it once, twice maximum in a set or a video. But that's just my opinion, and I like how you mixed it up and you did some glides in there. You did some head isolations, neck isolations, you did some roboting, waves. You had a pretty well-rounded variety of popping styles going on, which is good in my book. There was just a moment where the music dropped and you kind of stayed on the same intensity level, and which was really kind of chill and laid back. I felt like you should have adapted to the music a bit more. Just give your dancing some dynamic. You want to stay soft on the intro and then have a higher dynamic, more full out, 110% on the drop of an electronic music song like that. So that's just my opinion. But thanks for submitting, and let's get into the next video. So the next video was submitted by Christian Ink-Smith. Kill the beat. Nice pen from outside. like the location. Oh, speed change. Leading with the head. Passed it with a Hadouken to his homie. I like the button down too, that's classy. Nice. I like those parts where you guys are together. Very cool. Nice combo. Really cool combo. I like that teddy. Big, deep body wave. Very cool. I like the lean back too with the waves. Something I like to do a lot. Cool, nice touch, man. Really good touch, really good waves. Going with the music, like what I was just saying in the last video. He's with the music. It slowed down and he slowed down. He's building up and he's picking up intensity. Let the music guide you. See, now he's on the drop, the steps. Not on the drop, on the build. The touch going. Yo, that float drop thing, that was sick. That was dope, dude. I like how you guys are passing it like right on the music, right when it should. I like the spin burger touch because it was really clean. Sick video. Props Ink Dash, man. That was a really good video that had like a beginning, a middle, and an end, which all the other videos in this episode hadn't had. Respect, that was really cool. I liked how in the beginning it panned into you. It gives like this cinematic feeling. It brings the audience in to focus on your video. And it worked. I was already in it right from the beginning, right when you panned. The footage is a little shaky, and I know that's how it is when you have a smartphone, but other than that, I really liked all these, the aspect of the cameraman dancing with the dancers. I think that's really cool and adds a great effect to dance videos in general. I also really liked the fact that you guys were a duo and you had these little commandos or little short routines to transition from each other's solos. So that was really cool. I liked the Hadouken, and then you guys like did a huge quick pan to the left, and that was to your friend who I didn't even know who was gonna be there. But I love when I see that effect. It's really cool, and it's always a cool way to surprise the audience and keep the audience engaged in your video. You guys being so intertwined together as far as style and movement goes really added to the composition of your video. So I really liked the video as a whole. It was probably my favorite out of the four, so respect to you guys. Now, as far as the dancing goes, there's not much I could really say. I'm a popper and there's a lot of techniques going on here. There's a lot of flexing, a lot of tutting, and that's more of the new school tutting I see. And I'm not an expert on these subjects, but there is something that I could give you guys tips on is your waves, since we all share waves throughout all of these different dance styles. I would work on isolation, and that is moving one part of your body at a time while the other parts of your body rest in place. And what I mean by that is, as I move parts of my body, the rest of it stays isolated. It's kind of the same concept with roboting, moving one piece of your body at a time. But I think if you added a little bit more of the isolation to your waves, instead of just waving and kind of letting it go all over the place, you can kind of focus the wave energy where you want and even bring the wave where you want and get more creative with it because you have more control over it. So that's just my opinion. But otherwise, I really liked your style. I really liked everything about the video, honestly. So if you want to take my advice on isolating your waves, you can. But if not, you guys are already headed in the right direction. So big up on that. And that was the last video for this first episode. So I hope you guys all enjoyed this. If you guys want to submit your own videos or you want to submit questions for the future question and answers, please leave your links and questions in the comments below. I will try to answer and accommodate everybody who leaves them, whether it be in the video or in a DM or in the comments. I always try to reply to everybody. So thank you guys for submitting your questions and your videos. That brings this episode to an end. So hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope you may have learned something. I hope I didn't offend anybody. And if I did, I didn't mean to. I was just hoping to educate others and hopefully get everybody to get a little bit of dance information from this short video. So keep that in mind and subscribe if you haven't. Thanks for watching. And until next time, peace.